Welcome to classes by Inspire Physics. Today we are going to see the expression for the energy stored in an inductor during a self-induction process as well as the energy density. See, we have an inductor, or we can say it's a solenoid. Our heading is energy stored. Energy stored in an inductor. So in an inductor, energy is stored in the form of magnetic field. See, we have a solenoid. The solenoid is connected to a cell, and suppose we have switch also to vary the current. I is the current. See, let E be the EMF induced. When we switch on or switch off, there will be change in magnetic flux and EMF will be induced in the coil. Okay, we need to find the expression for the energy stored. First, we will see what is the EMF induced. E is equal to, we know the equation, minus L into di by dt. This is a change in current and this is the inductance. EMF induced. When you take the magnitude alone, we can say E is equal to L into di by dt. Okay. Now we need to find a power. The power corresponding to the voltage. If I is a current, we can say we have power is equal to V into E into I. Voltage into current. See, how can you write the power? Power is equal to E into I means L into I into di by dt. Now what is the work done? See, power is related to work done, because we know a work power is equal to work by time. So work done is equal to, you can say the small work done is equal to we'll write work is equal to power into time. We can say P into dt. In a small duration of time, the work done. What's the need of this work done? Because when current is flowing through the solenoid, when there is change in current, when you switch on or switch off, there is change in magnetic field, change in current. During this process, an EMF will be induced, that is due to self-induction. See, this EMF has a tendency to oppose the EMF developed by the battery. See, the induced current will oppose the current produced by current actually flowing in the circuit. See, there is current flowing in the circuit and there is a current induced due to self-induction. It will try to oppose. That's why that EMF is called a back EMF. So there will be opposition. So the battery need to do some power, but need to spend some energy to overcome the opposition. So that will be the power. Let's DW with a small work done by the battery to send the charges. Okay, even though there is back EMF to oppose it. See, P into dt. Now we can write DW is equal to, what is P? P is equal to LI. Okay, then we have dt into di by dt. Okay, now we need to find the total work done. So what we can find? The total work done W is equal to when current is starting from 0 to I. See, current should grow from 0 to I. During this time, there will be opposition created by the back EMF. See, current should increase from 0 to I. We need to integrate this expression. We can say Li into Di. We are going to integrate this. When integrating, L is taken outside. We can say L integral 0 to I Di. Okay. So when you integrate, what will you get? L into, we will get di integral is equal to it is equal to I square by 2. When you apply the limits, lower and upper limit, we will get half L I square. This is the equation for what? The work done. This work done is stored as energy. So we can say energy stored in inductor, U is equal to, this work done is equal to half L I square. Okay. Now we'll see, we have seen energy stored in inductor. Okay, now we have energy density. What is energy density? I can give a simple, energy density means energy by volume. Energy by volume. See, there will be magnetic field surrounding the solenoid and the energy will be produced within this region, within the solenoid region. See, energy stored per volume we will find. We will find the volume of the solenoid. Let L be the length of the solenoid and this A be the area cross section. Area cross solenoid. We need to find the volume. How will you find the volume? The volume is equal to length into area cross section. See, L into A will be the volume. So energy by volume. Now we can write UD is equal to, energy is half L I square divided by, we will divide the volume, L into A. L into A will be the volume. Okay. Now we'll modify these two equations, I, L and I. We know that self-inductance having an equation mu zero N square A divided by L. We know the equation for self-inductions. And the magnetic field within the solenoid is given by B is equal to mu 0 N by L into I. This is the magnetic field. Okay, we need to get I. What is I from this equation? I is equal to BL by mu 0 N. We have got a L and I that we will substitute here. So energy density UD is equal to half into, what is L? Mu 0 N square A divided by L. Then I square, squaring this, B square L square by mu 0 square N square. This we need to divide. So we just divide this, take the reciprocal L into A. This we are dividing, so take the reciprocal. Okay. Now what will you get? UD density is equal to mu 0, 1 mu 0 cancels, N square completely cancel, L cancels. Okay. See, we have not dividing, it should be in the denominator itself. So there is a mistake. It will be 1 by L into A. Now what we have, we divide L, L into L is L square, that cancel with this L square. Now what is left to half, A also cancel. You will get half B square by mu 0. This is the equation which we have. This equation is the energy density. What is energy density? Energy per volume. See, within the solenoid there will be magnetic field. In the form of magnetic energy, we have the energy stored. And per volume, what's the energy stored? It is equal to half B square by mu 0. Okay, so the we have divided the volume. What's the volume value? Volume having value L into A for the solenoid that we have divided here. When you divide here, L into A cancels. So, and what is left ultimately? Half B square by mu 0. This is called a energy stored in an inductor. Energy as well as energy density. Okay, thank you.